And this is the start of Omanz against Sirichoke. We're going to call him wrong in the black trunks there. This fight is brought to you by Fairtex. Be inspired. And that Muay Thai kicking style landing early on to the outside of Omanz's thigh.
Oh!
And soccer kicks to the head a little bit wild.
Someone's aggressive.
Oh, good right hand from Rong. Follows it up with a clubbing left as well.
Yeah, he's showing why Lupini Stadium is one of the best places to go watch a fight.
Kicks to the head. What a furious pace and another good right hand.
Rong is just finding the mark too. It's just intense. He is not afraid to get in there and bang.
He's landing with some accuracy, Jason, as well. He's banging, as you say, but as you say, finding the mark. It's very few wasted punches.
Yeah, and it looks like that really put Omanz on the back pedal a little. He's a little hesitant to let his hands go.
Second time he's kind of lost his balance when he's missed on the kick, which could expose him if
Omanz
can get in there. He does this. Yeah. He's solid, solid Muay Thai fighter as well.
Oh, and a nice right just straight down the pipe.
Omanz has really got to lift his guard because he's getting caught on the chin numerous times already. We're a minute and 15 seconds into this fight.
Omanz keeps keeping his left hand down extremely low. He already ate a couple to the jaw. You'd think he'd want to keep those hands up and protect, keep that chin down.
Boxer against Thai boxer.
Oh, nice kick. Connects again. See, Omanz looking for that over to the right.
Left knee is taking some punishment.
That is a good takedown by Omanz.
Yes.
Get to see how Rong works out of guard. This is really going to be a litmus test to see how much he's evolved, no pun intended.
Neither of these fighters thought to be particularly at home on the ground.
Omanz wants to sit up and get posture so he can create some space. Right now you see that Rong has his arms just kind of locked up, holding the head down. You might get sit up from this position, but you have to be careful that the referee doesn't give you a yellow card. You saw there Rong started to work a little bit of an elevator sweep. You can tell he's been working his jiu-jitsu, just maybe not 100% comfortable to take that risk. Because you know that if you miss that sweep, you're really going to give your opponent an opportunity to pass, but it looks like back to the feet.
Olivier Cost, yeah, standing them up. This is where the action could get furious again, but the takedown attempt again.
Another take, well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, right? I mean, that's two takedowns in a row, and I think that's a smart maneuver. Oh, man, just keep working out of guard there, but
it's one good way of stacking up the points.
And we just talked about when you're punching inside guard, you want to have both hands in or both hands out past those legs. And it looked a little bit like Rong was trying to set up a triangle, maybe showing his hand a little bit early. But if Omanz sits back and tries to unleash on him, he's going to throw those legs up and try to wrap up that head. Or just kick off, which is another good strategy, back up to the feet.
Gets up quickly.
Kick.
He's often going for that kick to,
You know Heath's in the corner just yelling right now, like a thousand different ways to defend a single leg. Elbows to the back of the head work too. I don't think they had those when Heath was wrestling in the Olympics, though.
Goes to the stomach and the head, getting.
Oh, that was just a nice one right across the side.
Sucker kick to the head.
To
follow it up with the right hand.
Yeah, went to kick the extra point there and just missed.
Just missed, didn't he?
That's how you stuff a double leg takedown. And a nice
right
ground
hands.
And pound action here.
Under pressure now.
Rong stand right on top with good pressure.
The Filipino is in trouble, taking a
this
knee
could
to
be
the
it.
Head with his head pressed down. We may not see too much more of this. And indeed, Olivier Cost steps in. He was pushing his head into the canvas so that he was a sitting duck. He was not moving. That head was just glued to the deck. In came the knees, in came the punches. And Rong takes the win on his mixed martial arts debut. Both of these guys making their debuts And he sims there, delighted with his man. Learning all the time about his ground game, Rong, and he sims is saying that that's the area that needs work, understandably, come through his debut, though.
And Rong must not have cut much weight, too. When we were at the hotel, we saw him eating before the weigh-in. So sitting at the table, he was knocking back some
that's
food.
That's a man just who's like, confident about his weight.
Yeah, just like he was knocking back opponents here. He just missed with that hit, but he was finding the mark over and over again. Out of range, comes back in with that short elbow. That's very Muay Thai. He ate a couple of overhand rights in exchange for those low kicks. You can see Oman was loading those up. And even though he got taken down a couple of times, Omanz really wasn't able to capitalize on it. And finally, in that third takedown attempt, Rong said, oh, that's right. He showed me how to stuff these like a Thanksgiving turkey. Got push on that head, good balance.
In the end, it was the technique of holding that head down, though, so that he couldn't get out of the way, couldn't move himself. Oh, brutal stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a hold to this battle with 27 seconds remaining in round number one. For your winner, via referee stoppage due to strikes, Dejdamrong Sor Amnuaysirichoke!
Jomanz Omanz not there for the official decision. He's sitting on his stool, but he's walking out, or limping out, I should say, but he seems to be okay.